Alright. Hello, and it's another day of do my dailies. Before they end, I would have liked to have continued the actual Final Fantasy XIV stuff yesterday, and or the day before that, but of course, here we are. Despite saying we would continue after she gets home, Aki has now been home for 2 days, and of course we can't do anything, because why would we be able to? So we will do the Amalja stuff today and unlock the next tier reputation, right? Yeah. We'll be unlocking that, and then we'll do the next, I think, six for them. And then I'll probably just pop back and do three for Sahagin. I'm not sure, but we'll see. So, a shell to scry on. Is this the one about... Oh no, this might actually be a different one. Yeah, that one's actually, I think that's a new one. I don't remember doing that before. Blitzing the beacons, we've done that one before. Okay, and then losing one's tempered, which I think we also did. Is that the one that has to do with those other people that we have to splash stuff on? Yeah, unfortunate Mikote, okay. Alright. This should be easy peasy. So we've got about an hour, just like before. I just woke up before things reset for us, and I'm just going to do them and hope and pray that maybe Aki will actually play today. Because unfortunately, I was worried about this exact thing happening because it's happened before when Aki goes on trips, and I just thought it would be perfectly okay because Aki's trip was only 4 days. Like, okay, that's much shorter than I'm used to, so that means it shouldn't be too bad. But of course, it being a short trip, and it still come home, despite saying we were going to do this or that after coming home, and nope, couldn't. Split to the next day, nope, couldn't. So now it's basically the length, almost the length of a normal one of her trips, which is between a week and 11 days. And, yeah. So I'll just have to wait and hope that maybe today we can play, or tonight, or whatever, continue. I mean, it doesn't help that, Oh, you can heal, can you? I didn't know that. Alright, here, how about you have some of this, my dude? Well, this is a different area. It doesn't help that we've got Aki's witch of a mother just being a total fucking awful parent as per usual. And unfortunately, Aki loses all willpower to make decisions for herself when that happens, so that's only making matters 10 times freaking worse than normal. It's not the first time it's happened. This is blitzing the beacons down here. Can I see the beacons? Are they in the same place? It looks like they are in the same place again. Get rid of big old beacon man. Can you get rid of this guy just because I don't have to, but might as well. He's fighting me, so... Over and get the other beacon now. It'll be dandy landy wandy. Apparently this other guy now is attacking me. I've never had that happen, I don't think. Maybe I walked too close to him. the last of you out of the way. And now we have to kill a tortoise. How the hell do I know what the big tortoise is? There it is. Right, and done. Actually, hold on. Whenever I ride Torgol, you go to Mount Guide. Same thing happen here? Yeah, okay. This full bar down here turns into a pet bar, which means I wouldn't need... I'm very curious as to why that... I don't remember it doing that, but I guess it does that. Seems I don't need this pet, this other bar up here that shows up. Getting more random items from some of these enemies. Might be useful someday for crafting, who knows. Now Mr. Amalgaman, Hamujga, has got the next piece of the story for me. Let's have a peek. I didn't know we had a Mikote settlement. Okay. Well, we're not gonna leave. She might be a bit feisty, but we won't leave her without a helping hand. So there's a Mikote settlement down here? This is one of the things I had to do for the actual daily before, basically. The last one's up there. I'll come down here first. Oh, okay. You do have to be pretty close. I think you wouldn't want to sit right next to one of these if they explode in your face, but whatever, who knows. No Final Fantasy expert. Yet. Hello. Right, they are gonna attack. I don't know why they were just sitting there for a second. I don't have to kill these guys, it doesn't look like, but I will, just because why not? Archer versus Archer. He's dead. Hello, Unapa.
I can turn this off for right now.
Okay. Interest. Looks like most of this quest is to learn more about little Mikote over here, little Tsundere. No, I did not exactly help you cross the sands, but... Oh, that's from the shop. I've seen that. I guess you can, when you see a sprout riding something big and badass like that, you can probably assume it was purchased. My blood sister. Oh, what? No, I don't think so. I guess this is the Mikote encampment back here. I've been here before. I guess I never realized it was Mikote specific. Okay. So she thinks kidnapping, I guess. Big-ass worm fight going on out here. Hello there. Sweet-smelling huntress. Okay, now we gotta go back and actually confront her about it, I guess. Hopefully she doesn't get too angry at me for digging into her personal past. Moment, I still have a little over half of a month's worth of subscription left for this game at the moment. I'm hoping I can resubscribe so we can continue, but if Aki starts doing this kind of stuff, well, we're never going to actually catch up in time for the expansion pack or that's releasing at some point. I say expansion pack as if it's an old game, but which is what Aki wanted to do and kind of what I was hoping to do, but and especially because things were actually getting really interesting as soon as we started Heavensward. But yeah. So hopefully Aki will come back and get on the ball again, hopefully. We'll see. Let's just say I'm not really holding my tongue for that these days. How would they are right and wrong? I don't know. Okay, character development for the brown Mikote out here in the middle of the desert. Oh, didn't we unlock the new thing? Reputation up. We have now achieved a recognized reputation with Brotherhood of Ash. No amount of tribal quests from Naruj Ba. Okay, so I have to remember it's actually a different NPC this time. But I will still do all of the available quests regardless. Selection of wares, but again, I doubt it's anything super special. And a new achievement. So this guy over here has the big ones for us. Right where it hurts. Okay, so we already did three, so this will be three again, and then three again, which will be nine, so I'll only have three left, which we'll do with Sahagin. And then from tomorrow onwards, or I guess later today onwards, I'll simply do six for Sahagin and six for Amalja, and we'll just focus on those two factions until they're done. So these are new quests. Let's see. Is your deeds honored ally? Ew. Okay, so just basically some fighting, this infernal heat. Some more beacons. Destroy infernal beacons. It's just a beacon one again? So far these aren't very different to what I've been doing. Water. Well, I mean, I guess that makes sense. I didn't realize that thing behind him is bouncing up and down. Seek out Flame Ring Ravagers and douse them with water upon their defeat. Oh wait, he's only got one quest for us? What? That didn't happen with... Alright, hold on, let's just go do these three quick. I'm pretty sure that did not happen when we were doing the Sahagin stuff. I'm almost positive that the Sahagin I had three extra quests for. But maybe not? Well, I don't know, how many... Let me see, adventure... No, I keep forgetting where this is at. 72. Yeah, that would have had to have been X... Yeah, that was. So then what the fuck? What? Alright, I'm confused. What am I here for? Hello? What is this? Douse them while they're down. Okay. I see not my objective. Seek out Flame Ring Ravagers and douse them with water. Oh, shit, there's a purple. I bet that thing was standing on it. Now, it says douse them with water upon their defeat, so... It's like they're doing the same thing. Oh, they are literally doing the same thing and they just one-shot the guy. It feels to be weak as hell. Okay, now what's up here? Just more of the same. Yep. This is basically just an evolution on that Mikote one that we were doing. Okay, and now we got these guys we have to defeat. Or obtain things from, but gotta defeat them to do that. those ones done, and now we need to this infernal heat, which is to destroy the beacons. But it, I don't know, it's quite a wide area. It could be anywhere. They're not necessarily up here, are they? Like, is that one? That's one. So it looks like the beacon one is the same thing again, but in different area. Anomo looks like a tiny little onion or something down there, radish. Because she is a vegetable. Dowsing, I guess. Fly on over here and try that quick. Okay, I was gonna say, I see the yellow marker over here for an for one of the like objectives or whatever, quest objectives on the map. So, like, that is way outside the area that it wants me to search in. Alright, and there's our first next tier stuff done for Amalja. Will not be the last, I'm certain of that. I wonder if you unlock even better quests then on the next reputation upgrade. So we'll just have to wait and see. It'll be a few days before we get to see that again. Here you go. Challenge completed. Okay, now you... Okay, so he still only has one left, and I don't... That did not happen with the Sahagin, so I don't know what's going on there. So I guess I'll do it, and then we'll just do 5 quests for the Sahagin then. Is that person also doing their Amalja reputation? What? way the hell up over here. Is the Thaumaturge gonna get pissed off because I'm grabbing a random crate next to him? Nope. Okay, that one was straightforward. Two people talking to them. All right, here you go. Here you go. You can tell this wasn't a very important little mini quest because all the items have basically a copy paste description just with a slight change. And he has no more for us because for some reason I didn't get the extra three. I only got one. So I don't know what was going on there. I don't know why the Sahagin were different, but yeah, now the Imelja are up to 52, Sahagin up to 72, so I'll just go and speak with the Sahagin. I guess I could speak with one of the other ones, but I'm going to talk with the Sahagin, so let's go Nazca, and we'll go to Western. We're making plenty of gil off of this that I feel okay doing this right now, even though if you add up the amount of gil I've spent in the past, like, 2 days from teleporting around, it's like multiple thousands of gil, which I don't care if you get more gil later. The fact that I could save that over time, that means hundreds of thousands of gil have built up teleporting, but right now I'm still kind of low on time. You know, we only got about half an hour, give or take, before things reset. And I'll probably also run off to Limsalamenza quick, because I'm sure that my mission is done, that we had our, one people doing. Okay, so for this, since I only have 5 allowances, I will take the 3 from this guy. Learn by destroying. I don't remember all the names yet, so... Looks like we're going to a ship again. Move along, nothing to heal here. I think this one's new. In the shadow of the moon. And I'll yoink 2 from this guy. Standard procedure. And do that stuff at the moment. Standard procedure. Hello. Oh, I gotta use this. We need to slay Shultooth Sahagin in this place. That should be easy enough to do. That's not what I wanted to press, but whatever. One more. Ah, there we go. What is this guitar going on? Alright, that's that done. And now we got to take Mr. Fish Thing out to the ships and stuff. Shadow of the Moon. So we need to find a dispatch, a bunch of bullshit. Serpent Reavers. Okay, is there a way that I need to spawn these guys? Because there's no Serpent Reaver here. It says right over here, though. Oh, I see. Okay, I just gotta go into the area. Who's next? You? More? Still on the map, but there's two places on the map, four things we gotta take down, so I'd assume two each. Alright. Mission accomplished. Wind from their sails. So we just have to do two more ship things. Just a bunch more fighting, and then we're done. Take down like 20,000 enemies. I can hardly see the things I have to attack over there. Right. Mission accomplished. Now, can I... No. Okay. You can, apparently, equip a mount here, but you can't take it over to the other ships. I was just checking to see if I could, so that I don't have to go back just to come back out. Last one. So this time we just need to slay four of these guys. That sounds simple enough. Okay. And that's it for my stuff today. And that puts us up to 134 reputation with them, which is a little bit... It's going to be offset a bit, because I did one less thing for them. For some bizarre reason why Amalja had... It didn't let me do as much as I was hoping for them, but whatever. I guess I'll just have to wing it. Okay, now Upper Lanoska. Okay, we can go to the Lanoska decks down there. Just gonna do that so I can get my squadron going on another frickin' thing. Until the game ultimately tells me what I need to do. If it ever fucking does. To actually rank up in my grand company again. Oh, fishingman. Oh, that is the right one. Ugh, God, why did that taste like blood? Mission was successful. Okay, good. It's freaking sad. Hope so. Although somebody looks like they're a little bit oofed. Looks like I could do the supply wagon thing. It's a full 100 points off there. I think our squadron is equal to the task. I mean, they have an up on the rest of this stuff, so maybe. Should I try it? Yeah, why not? I don't know, we'll see what happens when something goes wrong. Okay. And I will just go out and speak with Mr. Man again, but we'll see. I doubt he's going to say anything different. Yep, no further ranks available to you. Thank you, game, for doing a good job of explaining why. Okay, anyways, that's going to be it for this episode. We did our dailies for right now, and I'll hopefully do them again later. I'll wait and see if Aki can play tonight before I go to do those dailies. Otherwise, I'll just do them tomorrow morning like I'm doing right now. But currently it doesn't look pretty good. It doesn't look very good, but well, sometimes Aki actually manages to pull through with the stuff she says we're going to do or that she's going to do, but we'll just wait and see.